Hello, and welcome to week 8 of the state legislature and our final week. The legislature is expected to sine die on Thursday. We will do our final wrap-up report on the following week after we see all the bills that passed and died and get a really good recap for you. But this past week has been very excited and a lot of hard work. This Saturday, the bag bill passed. The version that passed out of the House and will be concurred with in the Senate is acceptable to us. It bans the film plastic bags statewide by January 2021 and requires retailers to collect 8 cents on every paper bag, or if they carry the 2.25 mil plastic bag, 8 cents on that bag, except for communities where 10 cents is already implemented. It does a number of other things, and it's outlined in our report at the end of this video. You can click on our website and read more, and we can give you the full text of the bill. The other great thing that happened on Saturday for our pharmacies was a passage of the Pharmacy Benefit Manager Bill, which requires them to register and prohibits the DIR or the clawback fees. This is so significant, it will serve as a model in the United States. Two bills that actually passed dealing with privacy. One of them was to prohibit the use of facial recognition. Now this is a problem. The House killed our theft bill, and now they have said we can't use facial recognition for shoplifters. So without their permission, of course. So I guess you just have to run out in the parking lot after your shoplifter and ask permission to use their photograph with local law enforcement. It is just, it's hard to understand how the House of Representatives can pass these types of pieces of legislation. Also, the privacy bill dealing with data and who has to report what to whom in the government. There is a good amendment on there, and a shout out to Carolyn Logue, our contract lobbyist, who got an amendment in the bill. It exempts the transactions by our stores that have simple transactions. So unless you have a loyalty card, you won't be subject to this bill. The continued fight is with the carbon. There were 100 logging trucks that showed up to protest the carbon or the low standard fuel tax bills that the legislature is considering. It had quite an impact at the Capitol. And the vapor bill is still sitting in the Senate, and we hope that's where it will stay. We have also done a lot of activity on COVID-19 and hope you will look at our website. First, we worked with the Department of Health, and they have suspended the inspections of your inventories for WIC. There's been a run on baby food and formula, and so we are having a hard time in some of our stores keeping up the inventory. So they are suspending those inspections, there'll be further information coming to you. The other thing we're doing is when the vice president was in the state last week, Congresswoman Morris Rogers was with the congressman and the director of CDC. We had put a bug in her ear that we could really use a suspension of the truck's hours of service because of the crunch that our stores are feeling with some products. Our warehouses are right up against their hours of service and have not been able to fulfill those orders. So stay tuned, keep looking at our website. We'll keep you up to date with everything we can get on COVID-19 for you. Thank you, and talk to you next week.